G'day, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. Welcome to this video in my free math worksheet series. The worksheets this week come from this ebook. It's a book accompanying our software, Classroom Professor Gadgets, and the book is called Number Facts, because that's one of the gadgets. If you look on the cover, you can see a picture of the software. It's basically got a number fact grid in the middle and a number of tools that you can use to investigate the number fact. So, not our usual set of worksheets. So this is not simply to develop fluency as such with number facts, but to explore the patterns in the number facts. So it's a supplement to the other sets of worksheets that I normally talk about, to help students to more thoroughly understand the number facts and to investigate what they can see in them, which is what the software is for. So this particular set of worksheets we're calling number fact families A, B, C, and D in multiplication. Now, it's actually multiplication and division. And because we're starting from A, we've got harder ones that go on beyond that, but we start with the easiest multipliers and then we move on. So we've got times 2, times 5 and 10, times 3 and times 4. Okay. So what do we mean by number fact families? Quite simply, we want the students to see that when they know one number fact and they know it really well, there's a cluster of four number facts usually, I'll talk about that in a minute, but there's generally a cluster of four number facts that go together, that belong together, as Sesame Street used to say. They're in a sort of family. Because they use the same numbers. So here's an example. 2 times 7 equals 14. What associated number facts are there for that example, children? Well, if we're going to reuse the same numbers, the answer's not that difficult. We can do another multiplication fact that we can call a turnaround fact. The technical name is it's commutative. The operation is commutative. I used to get all those terms mixed up, but I've realized that commutative is a bit like commuting. If you commute to work, you go backwards and forwards. A commutative rule, principle, is you can turn the two of them around. 2, 7, 7, 2. Same thing, it's commutative. Okay, so that's another one. Then we've got two other facts. If we start with the 14 and divide, again, we've got two examples. 14 divided by 2 is 7. 14 divided by 7 is 2. So there is our cluster or family of number facts. And notice you only have to, effectively, you only have to learn one of those and you know the other three. So if you focus your attention on this as a group of number facts, you're being efficient. You know, you're being strategic about learning the number facts. You're certainly not using an old-fashioned rote method. I don't know if you remember doing rote methods at school, but I do. And we would go 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s. Even the easy ones, we just keep repeating them. And the hard ones, we just say them once or twice each. 2 6s are 12, 2 6s are 12, 2 7s are 14, 2 7s are 14, 2 8s are 60. If you do that long enough, you will learn your number facts. However, if you forget one, you probably have to go all the way through the whole sequence before you can find it. That's actually the problem with singing the number facts. You may have come across this idea that if we put it all to music, then children will learn it because learning a song is relatively easy. Yes, they will learn it. Yes, they will learn the song. But if they forget one partway through the song, they'll have to sing the whole rotten song before they get to it. All right. So if you were learning the 2 times number facts and you knew 2 7s are 14 using that method, you might not even think about 7 2s are 14, and you wouldn't ever get down to the dividing by 2 and dividing by 7 as well. This is, as I said, a more strategic approach. So we'll focus on these four number facts together. And the worksheets, as you'll see, will show the students, early on we have all four of them, but without the right-hand side, the answers, as it were, and they just have to be filled in. And then later on, we just give the students one or two of the number facts, and they figure out the rest and, you know, fill them in as families of number facts. So, as I said, it's a strategic approach. It's it's a way to help the students think about the fact that perhaps they know more than they thought they did, you know, or that they can reuse knowledge. You know, the idea that you can take something meant for one purpose and repurpose it. It means you don't have to create everything again. It's a bit like, you know, if you're writing any sort of Word document, generally you've got one you did before that you can reuse and repurpose it and just change little bits. It's very much like that. If you already know 2 sevens of 14, then you should know 7 twos of 14, and you should know the divisions that go with it, and so on. Okay, that's the end of this video. You might recognize that I've started doing these videos in sets because I'm wearing the same shirt and tie week after week. This is the last one of this set. We're now up to 66 weekly sets of worksheets. I do hope that you enjoy them. I'd love to hear your feedback. So now's a good point, time for me to stop for a moment and say, please leave me some feedback. Give me a comment, send me an email, find us on Facebook, whatever you'd like to do. But I'd really like to hear how you're finding the videos and the worksheets. Let me know if you've got some topics you'd like to see covered, and I'd just love to hear from you. That's it for this week. I look forward to talking to you next time.